My name is Monica Yearwood, and I'm the founder of Hamsa Ayurveda and Yoga in Chicago. And today, I want to share the ingredients of my favorite anti-aging facial oil. So the first thing that I want to teach you is how I made the base oil. So this is the base oil of my favorite anti-aging skin serum. And so what I did was I took organic red rose petals, and I twice sifted them, and I removed all the petals and the stems, and I ground them into a fine powder. And I also took organic calendula flowers, and I ground those into a fine powder. And I put them in this glass jar, and I filled up the glass jar with olive oil that actually came from a friend's family farm in Greece. And it's been sitting on my windowsill for about 6 weeks, and every day I shake it. So my oil smells amazing. It smells really like a beautiful flower garden on a nice warm spring or sunny day. It's got a very herbal and tea-like smell to it. So the next step is to strain the oil. More oils to the base oil. I added about a half a cup of jojoba. Jojoba is fantastic because it's so easily absorbed by the skin. And the great thing about that is if you're using it with essential oils, and essential oils are the oils that are mostly known for their aromatic properties, so like rose or jasmine, but also have chemical constituents in them that influence our skin as well as our mood and our physiology. So you can choose different essential oils that have different benefits and effects. And I'm going to tell you about the essential oils I'm going to add in to this mix in just a moment. So jojoba again is great because it's so easily absorbed into the skin, so it doesn't block or get in the way of the absorption of any essential oils that you may be adding to your combination. I also added about a half a cup of amaranth seed oil. And amaranth seed is an amazing oil for anti-aging that has a lot of clinical research to back up its effects and being able to stimulate collagen production, which is, of course, is sometimes a concern as we get older. And it's incredibly potent. So we only need to add between 5% to 20% of this oil to your total combination. The next thing that I did add to my oil is calendula oil that's been CO2 expressed. So in the essential oil world, you have several different methods of extraction. The most popular are distilled, so that's where you use steam to extract the active ingredients out of the plant or the resin or whatever it is that you're trying to get the essence or the essential oil from. And then you also have hexane, so that's a chemical solvent that's used in a chemical extraction to make absolutes. And so absolute essential oils tend to have a very fragrant smell to them, and we use those more in natural perfumery. So you don't want to use an absolute on your skin because of the hexane, the chemical extraction method. And the most recent extraction method that we have is CO2. The reason why CO2 is so amazing, although it is a bit more expensive, but it also preserves the smell, so the aroma of the essential oil, which is great, but it also preserves its medicinal effects. So I have a calendula CO2 expressed oil, and a lot of the CO2 oils tend to be solid. I like to get my essential oils from Eden's Botanicals and White Lotus Aromatics in Seattle. Those are my two favorite companies that I use in my products. So the CO2, it comes out in a solid form, and you only need about 5%, 2 to 5% of your total oil base. So I dilute it in a carrier oil like sesame seed or almond oil. The essential oils that I chose for my combination are rose, white rose essential oil, which again I got from Eden's Botanicals. It is a pretty expensive essential oil. but it is so beautiful. It smells so amazing. And the rose essential oil again has a lot of farnesol in it. And farnesol is the active ingredient that a lot of luxury skincare companies will isolate from different plants and flowers because it is so good at stimulating collagen production. But rose also has a lot of influence over our mental disposition and well-being. In Ayurvedic medicine, rose is the queen of flowers that helps to restore devotion and love. So it's a great one to apply to your face and to your skincare for uplifting overall mood and mental well-being. And I also chose ambergris seed essential oil. Again, an extremely expensive essential oil, but has been used for thousands of years for its spiritual benefit, for bestowing a higher intuition and inner knowledge and knowing, but also has many different influences on the skin, like stimulating collagen production, and also helps to hold on to fluid and water, so which can help, with dehydrated skin or dull or lackluster skin. So with essential oils, you always want to dilute them. Sometimes I hear about some companies that are actually really well known, advising people to apply essential oils directly onto their skin, which can create a lot of different problems. Some essential oils are phototoxic, so that means that they react to sunlight, and then you can start to get rashes and blisters. Some essential oils, they're just too potent and they're too strong. They'll actually burn your skin. So you don't. There are some essential oils that you can apply directly. You can apply neat, like sandalwood is one of them. Lavender essential oil is another. But most essential oils you need to dilute. And if you're adding them, using them on your face, I would start, at a very conservative percentage. So between 2% to 7% would be high on the skin. So this is one of my favorite anti-aging oils that I include in my home-based detox programs here at Hamza and at a distance. Whenever somebody does a detox or a cleanse program with me, we go through a full interview process. We look at every area of their life and we identify exactly their motivation and their reasons for wanting to do a detox. In my practice, detoxification is always integrative. So there's not just cleansing and detoxing the physical body, but we're also looking at the emotional body and the mental body as well to create a comprehensive detoxification program, which should include amazing products like skin serums, but also body oils. I use teas, I use different medicinal spices to enhance digestive function. And individual blends that target different organ systems in the body. So sometimes, if a person has skin imbalances like rosacea or acne, we would be looking at different combinations to cleanse the liver. Whereas, if somebody suffered from water retention, sluggishness, fatigue, we would be looking at the lymphatic system. So identifying the way that toxicity manifests in the body and the different organ systems that it is impacting matters tremendously. Doing an out-of-the-box cleanse or a cleanse program that's sort of one size fits all may help your issues, but probably not a long-term solution for a comprehensive and really effective detox program that is built specifically for you and your constitution. So thank you so much for joining me today, and I hope that this information aids you on your path. If you would like to do a comprehensive detoxification program that is customized specifically for your constitution and body type, you can click the link below for some more information.